North Africa, which is Israel, is separated by the Suez Canal and is not part of Africa. And this canal was dug a few days ago. Are you okay in your head? We are on the same platonic stone, Africa and Middle East. And God created a garden east of Eden. Therefore, Africa is Eden. We need to decolonize this Jesus story and throw away a white Jesus with his idols. I don't believe in a white movie star from Hollywood who is supposed to have come around and saved me from my sins. How can a white boy with blue eyes die for Africans when they cannot even share land with us? Show me one white man who has died for a black man. Show me one white man. 25 million people dead in the sea on their way to America for slavery. 15 million people dead in Congo. 25 plus 15, 40 million plus people dead. And all their blood means nothing except the blood of a white boy. If you are going to do theology, do it correctly. Do it correctly and give me an option. If I want to believe in a white Jesus, I'll believe in a white Jesus. If I want to believe in a black Jesus, I'll believe in a black Jesus. But if you want to be true to the biblical text, then be honest as theologians. And I'm embarrassed to be sitting here as a theologian together with some of my theological friends who have gone to school to study. And when you come out of school to study, we actually continue to promote the wrong theology and push it in front of our own people. We have become the colonizers ourselves, Uncle Toms, who are sitting on the conscience of our people. Which is wrong. Which is wrong. How do you sleep at night taking money from widows and orphans? How do you sleep at night taking money from people who cannot afford food and bread because Jesus will bless them? For the past 15 years, they've been giving their offerings to you and their lives have not changed. What is the problem? Because you don't have faith. You don't have faith. When I'm fundis, do you have faith in collecting money from us? So we need to understand and deconstruct the whole picture and ideology of this white Messiah. And as long as we worship a white Messiah, my submission to you is that we are not worshiping the truth of the text. This is an academic exercise we're doing here. If you want to be true to the text, please, I bought a can of Coke. Can I drink the Coke? Can I drink the Coke? Don't tell me, just drink as long as you are drinking. I said I want Coke. Therefore, remove the unnecessary iconography.
Mama, couldn't we at least let black Jesus hang alongside?
Forget it. The only Jesus I know is him. And the one thing he don't need is a partner.
Mama, how do we know Jesus wasn't black? He could have been from the lost tribe of Israel. They were supposed to be black.
I bet they were. If ever people were lost, we're it.
Now just hush up, both of you. This picture has been in my family for as long as I can remember. When I was a baby, I don't know what I saw first. My mama, my papa, or this Jesus. Now he's the one I know and love. So let's close the subject.
Jesus was black, the Bible would have said so.
But it does say so.
What are you talking about?
I read about it. It's in Revelation chapter 1, verse 14. I read about it in Muhammad Speaks. It says, his hair is like wool, and his eyes are like flame of fire.
Well, Lord have mercy. You sure do say that, don't it?
And see, Mama, look at her hair, like wool, ain't it? And look at her eyes, red like fire.
Yeah, they sure is. Junior, how come you decided to paint this?
I don't know. All of a sudden, I just had divine thoughts on my mind.
And for JJ, that's a first.
What, having divine thoughts?
No, having a mind.
I guess I ought to be grateful for JJ having Jesus on his mind in any color.
Then we can hang him on the wall, Mama?
Well, now,
please, Mama.
All right. But just for Black History Week, after that he comes down.